In this video, I'm going to be talking about three particular gems that I believe are going to see some incredible gains over the upcoming months. So with that being said, let's get right into it. The very first particular project that I believe that's going to see some incredible gains is CODI. Now, CODI has seen some incredible growth so far over the past few months as well. And as of recent, they have been rewarded for all their hard work. So CODI is essentially a payment system, but it's a lot more than just a payment system that's going to be rivaling stuff like, you know, Stripe and PayPal and other companies like that. Now, for those of you who don't know how a payment processor works, you traditionally need a bank to underwrite all the payments that go through. So PayPal gets underwritten by banks, Stripe gets underwritten by banks. Essentially, a bank processes the payment. However, PayPal and Stripe and those companies, all they do is they're just the terminal. They're just accepting the actual card, right? So essentially, what CODI's trying to do is right over here, combat the traditional model. And CODI is the first enterprise-grade fintech platform that empowers organizations to build their own payment solutions and digitize any currency to save time and money. Now, here's the craziest part. Let me just cover this. Scalability. Typically, you can expect 25,000, and if you're looking at like Ethereum processes 20 transactions per second, which is TPS. And again, if you take a look at something like Visa, it's 25,000 transactions per second, but CODI can process over 100,000 transactions per second. Simplicity, right? CODI's user and merchant facing tools are seamless and easy to use, okay? Then CODI has cost effectiveness. CODI cuts out intermediaries and eliminates the need for costly mining because they're proof of stake. Then instant payments, price stability, security. CODI distributes ledger technology, eliminates a single point of failure for enhanced security, which is absolutely insane for those of you that are, you know, accepting payments as well. Not only that, but you also have the buyer-seller protection. So Trust Chain is their essential technology that they've built in order to make this all happen, essentially. So CODI has a lot going for them. They have a lot of partners. There's just so much. If you go and take a look at their Medium, which you can go and if you go to CODI.io, you go and take a look at their Medium and just go through their weekly updates and just take a look at, well, if you want to, read all of their updates and all the partnerships that they have. And they're actually going ahead and they just announced right here the debit card update. The cards are now being sent out to print. So take a look at this. Those who applied for a CODI debit card will receive an email with the instructions for opening a CODI bank account, right? A CODI Pay debit card will be sent to users shortly after they've completed this process. So they're doing a lot more than just accepting payments, right? For literally the internet. So this is going to be massive just because they're going after the giants that process payments online. This is huge. This is a massive project. We're gonna see some massive growth. And yes, currently the price has just surged. It's gone parabolic. However, you wanna buy the dips here and try to dollar cost average your way in. And just so you know, they also have a BSC pegged, a Binance Smart Chain pegged CODI token that you can also go ahead and invest in if you want, or you can just literally go ahead and go to Binance and use Binance to purchase CODI. So CODI is number one on my list right now, and let's move to number two. Number two is C3 or CHARLI. Now, what is CHARLI? I'm gonna quickly go over this because I've created another video about CHARLI and why it's so powerful, but there's two current ecosystems that I'm basically going 50-50 on, the Cardano ecosystem and the Polkadot ecosystem. Why? So right now there's a race to who can go ahead and launch a smart contract platform the fastest, the most reliable, and who can do it with scalability in mind as well. So when it comes down to the DeFi sector, or really a lot more than just DeFi, you need what's known as an oracle. And an oracle takes data and processes data from the real world, processes data, period, and it puts it into like a warehouse, if you will, and then spits it out into whatever the project needs it to be spit out to. So let's just take yield farming, for example, right? Do you ever wonder how those APYs are generated? Well, an oracle determines all of that information. So if you take a look at oracles as the biggest one, which is the grandfather of them all, is Chainlink. And if you've ever seen how Chainlink went from 2019 all the way up, well, I guess from inception, but I look at it from 2019 when it was like 50 cents or something like that. It was like 50 cents. And then 2 years later, now we're at $50. So the growth and the need for oracles is insane, especially with platforms like Polkadot and Cardano. And CHARLI3 is set out to be Cardano's decentralized oracle. So CHARLI3 is essentially trying to become the oracle for Cardano, the main oracle like Chainlink is for so many other projects. CHARLI3 is trying to be a Chainlink for Cardano. We've seen some slow growth happen already over here as well. And again, I truly do believe this has so much more to go to the upside in comparison to what we've seen right now. It's only $2.99 right now. But again, if we go and take a look at how many holders there are, there's only 6,259 holders. Now, if we just take a look at something, and again, this is like a real far stretch because Chainlink, yes, Chainlink is technically an oracle, but I want you to just get a concept of how many holders there are of Chainlink in comparison to how many there are of CHARLI3 right now. So if we just take a look at the holders of Chainlink, there's 530,000 holders in comparison to 6,259. So I hope you get the general idea of how much growth there is and how many holders there currently are when it comes down to CHARLI3. Now, the last project that I want to talk about is one that I was debating whether or not I actually wanted to add it to this video because number one, it's super volatile. And number two, it has the potential to go either way as of right now. And that project is known as UNIQ. Like if I refresh this, it's at 472, now it's at 481. The market cap is literally under 15 million, under 12 million, it's $11 million. And what UNIQ aims to do is they're essentially they're going to materialize NFTs. So if you own a piece of art that's an NFT, then you'll be able to go ahead and sell that through UNIQ on their marketplace, but you'll be able to put it on t-shirts, on hoodies, on literally whatever you want. You can materialize it. So the best way that I can explain it, and I made an entire other video about UNIQ, and you can find it somewhere around here in the description to get a better idea. But essentially, what you need to know is that, think Teespring, right? So if you don't know what Teespring is, I'll show you right now, Teespring. What Teespring is print on demand, is individuals can go on to Teespring and put designs on a shirt and essentially make sales of this particular shirt. And what happens is Teespring actually gets the shirt, they put the design on the shirt, they ship it to the customer, and then they'll pay you, or actually you'll collect the payment depending on how you do it. You can either sell it on the Teespring marketplace or you can put it on your own store like a Shopify website. You collect the payment and then Teespring takes their cut, etc. So UNIQ is aiming to do the same thing with their own marketplace. And right over here, if we just go to collection, you'll be able to see that they have their own marketplace that is, it's not available just yet. So if I click right over here, it's available in a few months. So they'll have their own marketplace where individuals who have, you know, NFTs, whatever it is, whatever NFT you own, maybe it's a CryptoPunk, you'll be able to go ahead and materialize it, put it on a shirt and sell it to other people. So even though other people won't be able to necessarily use your NFT because you own it, you'll be able to have exclusive rights to sell your own NFT, which again is huge because of the simple fact that I know how big the print on demand space is and the e-commerce ecosystem is as well. And it's massive and it's only gonna keep on getting bigger with more adoption of crypto. And not only that, it's only going to keep on getting bigger as more people start purchasing online. And we've seen the boom of e-commerce over the last few years. So just to recap, we have CODI coming in at number one for me. We have CHARLI3 at number two, and then we have a moonshot here with UNIQ. Now, if you're gonna invest, I'm not a financial advisor. I don't ever suggest you listen to me for literally any financial advice. But what I will say is that if you do decide to listen, UNIQ would be the one where if I had $1,000, I'd probably put like, you know, I'd probably put 400, 400 and 200 as an example. In regards to spreading it out, and 200 would be in UNIQ just because of how much of a moonshot this actually is, but the upside potential can be really, really good. So with that being said, those are the three picks that I personally think over the upcoming months, even the next year and a half, are just going to do exceptionally, exceptionally well. So let me know in the comments down below what your pick is and what you think is going to do exceptionally well as well. So with that being said, subscribe if you enjoyed this video, smash the like button, and I'll see you soon.